But first we just talked and, yeah. and talked about movies and talked about Godard. And because in those days, Godard was everywhere, you know, and we were watching. And we and I probably was the only low-budget cameraman in New York that he talked to who had seen as much or more Godard than he had. So that's probably why I got the job. That and bust that I could talk very fast. And then, you know, I read the script, and I mean, it's a marvelous script, and it's a marvelous movie. It's kind of sad to say that of all the movies I've shot, it's the one I'm proudest of, and it was only the third movie I ever did. That kind of life was all downhill from there in a weird way. But it was an amazing, amazing script and jobs of acting and everything. Oh, my God, what a movie. And it really does hold up, you know. And by then I had begun to figure out a sort of minimal lighting that one could do. It's a lit movie. It pretends to be a documentary, but in fact, it's quite theatrical. It's not realistic at all, you know? In many ways, it's not meant to be realistic. Motion, and there's, you know, he's walking up the street, and they dissolve the middle out of the shot, and then he's walking this way, and then he's right up here, and there are many parts of it that are not documentary. It's a documentary of their emotions, not a documentary of their lives. A documentary of Travis Bickle's emotions and the other people's emotions. It's documentary in that sense, but it's quite deliberately theatrical. Marty is a theatrical director, and I mean that as in pride. It's a wonderful theatrical director. And I lit it, and very deliberately lit it. It meant to be light, not meant to be documentary, although I didn't do huge amounts. And some of it is just a matter of letting you see enough to see. But sometimes it was meant to be dramatic lighting, you know, to point the eye to where to look in the frame, where to look to see what Travis is doing. I mean, it's an outrageous movie. He's burning roses and things. I mean, it's not preposterous, but it's like an opera, you know. It just woos along. It's wonderful. And again, I don't know whether we knew how wonderful it was as we were doing it. I can't remember. I think that we didn't know whether we knew or not, you know. We knew that some scenes and certain moments were way, way out there and wonderful, but whether it all added up and whether it made sense and everything, I don't know that we knew it. I didn't know it. I certainly didn't know it. Maybe Marty did. You'd have to ask him. But I sure knew that some things were, you know, all that, the famous scene in front of the mirror, you talking to me and all that, was when you saw it, just being there, you couldn't, I mean, it was, I'd never seen anything like it before, you know? I'd never seen a scene in a movie like that. And we knew that was pretty good and that various other things were pretty good. Many things. It's, you know, he goes to buy a gun from a guy with an old friend of Marty's, actually, and from a gun dealer in Brooklyn, and he holds the gun like that, and he moves the gun across there, and the camera goes with him and follows and over the gun, and you see people walking down there. And, you know, this is theater. This is not documentary. No, this
That's
is
a great shot.
Yeah, it's a great shot. Yeah. It's a wonderful shot. And it's full of that. It's full of, as I say, it's a documentary of their emotions. You know, and the famous thing where he's calling her on the phone and trying to get a date and she won't talk to him and he's going on and he's just on in front of the camera so embarrassed the camera just dollies away from him and won't look and looks down the hall, you know. This is theater. This is movies, not theater. This is artificially induced, you know. I mean, very consciously thought out with a point, not just to document it, but to document the emotions. The camera, I think it was Marty who finally said, you know, the camera's just so embarrassed that it doesn't want to watch you any longer. It's so dolly down. And then you hear him going on and on pathetically, you know, well, did you get my message? And did you get my, and then he walks into the frame and walks off into the night. And it's horrible. It's so ghastly and embarrassing.